Good evening, dear sir and ladies and gentlemen witnessing here now. My attempt was the tale of Red and Harry. I know these terms are not so much familiar with your knowledge. The unseen role of run-out legislation and white-collar seats. Especially today I'm going to talking about the film or the film industry that the society consider as a mode of entertainment. And I have to say the film is the most developed visual entertaining mode in the world. Therefore, film is not only an entertaining mode, but it's a need of the society. Therefore, I have to say the film industry for Sri Lanka, I think it's a blood relation to our society and to our people, because Sri Lankan people once crossed the borders of Sri Lanka, went to India and watched movies, especially people in Jaffna Peninsula. That's why I expressed that the people in Sri Lanka has a blood relation to the film industry in Sri Lanka. Therefore, the objectives of my attempt is to reveal the failures of the legal body, the National Film Corporation, the NFC, and provisions of the law in modern times, because we are specially focusing on the film industry and the legislation that controls the film industry. And the second one is to introduce an action plan to revive the Sri Lankan film industry, because that's the main need. And to elaborate the concepts of liberalization and professionalism must exist in the modern motion picture industry in Sri Lanka. Especially the key terms liberalization and professionalism is today those terms have deficiency in practical sense. And my attempt was to elaborate the concepts about liberalization and what is professionalism that should maintain in the film industry. So my sources are primary and secondary, and I used some exclusive interviews, and as secondary sources, books, newspaper articles, and statutes. And for the subject, that Harry and Red, we know Harry represents the celluloid era. Harry is a brand, a renowned celluloid camera brand, because without a camera, how can we define the motion picture or film? And red represents the digital era, and Red and Harry, analog and digital. And after I explain these terms, you will understand the disparity of analog and digital, and what are the modes we are using these days in Sri Lanka. And Ariflex ceased their celluloid camera manufacturing operations while Red innovates more on digital. That's the disparity. It reflects cinema is no more a state-owned mode of entertainment, but highly changing with technology. If Harry ceased its productions on or manufacturing on celluloid cameras, and Red innovates more and making digital packages, then how can we, or how can state control or regulate the modern cinema? This is the digital era, and Sri Lanka needs a novel managing structure of cinema. And in the introduction, the movie industry was an oligopoly. You know, the economic factors, oligopoly from 1950s to 1970s, in a closed economy. We know the Cinemas Limited, Ceylon Entertainment Limited, and Ceylon Theatres Limited were the three entrepreneurs or businessmen or companies that handled the whole cinema. Whole cinema means importation, production, and post-production, everything. And distribution and production of films handled by this oligopoly. Therefore, we can get a sense that without these three companies, people can't make films, people can't express their choice of films. Therefore, the oligopoly was the main economic factor of that time. State intervened to the industry in 1970 to break the oligopoly, because there were so many factions. The factions mainly supported to United Front government's election campaign in 1970, and they have included the requests made by the factions wings, because there were two factions, especially artists and professionals who supported to break the oligopoly, and the people who talked behalf the oligopoly, and people who opposed the oligopoly, they request to the government to establish a corporation. Therefore, enacted the State Film Corporation Act number 47 in 1971, and thereafter established the State Film Corporation in 1972. The State Film Corporation was established in 1972, but all the film distribution purposes were taken in 1976. The purposes or the objects, main objects of the corporation, film distribution, importation, sponsoring for productions are the main objects, and there are few powers that stated in section 4 of the act. Powers: acquiring, establishing, installing, and operating studios, and controlling and supervising and inspecting cinemas, controlling and establishing an installation of cinemas, and likewise there were many purposes or the powers and objects for the State Film Corporation. Unlike no other country countries have implemented or established such kind of authority to control the whole cinema industry. Therefore, the film roll or the celluloid, the main factor that consider as the what is film that equals to the celluloid, and concerned as a state property, because the one and only authority that hold the power that importing celluloid to the country is the State Film Corporation. Previously the oligopoly, the companies, three companies, and the open economy functioned after 78. Thereafter, the film, whole film industry and the film corporation revolutionized for many purposes. After 78, industry gradually entered for the open economy, and the State Film Corporation entered the National Film Corporation. Film importation deviated from corporation simultaneously. Distribution remained, as I told. corporation eliminated the director licensing system on film production. Director licensing system was because those days everyone cannot make a film, and therefore there was so much rules and regulations to direct films. Main factors of the industry was the film theater was the main only meeting place of the audience. Celluloid was the only media of filmmaking. The purposes of the laws and the corporation were to manage above and regulate industry, the main visual entity mode until 1980s. The NFC today, the objects of the NFC are not updated, especially not updated and not responsible. Functions of NFC are run out. Monopoly functions of a closed economy. NFC failed to promote modern blueprints of cinema and failed to provide knowledge and sources to the industry as a regulator. The updation is the most significant problem that today the legislation and the corporation have. The dropped professionalism. The white collar regime distanced the film art and film professionals. That's called, they will make a huge disparity. Corporation failed to maintain the quality of film art because last decades we very well spoke about the quality of the film. Until the Saroja came in 1999, the film art was so much of rubbish as the people concerned. The act failed to define the modern cinema and the technology upgraded. Sri Lanka, the only Asian country to hold a large state authority regarding a motion picture industry. You know, motion picture industry is just a business, and still now Sri Lanka is controlling, a state is the controlling body of the motion picture industry. Law as a professional. The Cinematograph Act, India, 1952. Duties are defined terms, certification of films and examining films, and there are no objects or no special powers regarding industry. The liberalization, they were allowing the industry to grow as a liberal industry. Conclusion. NFC not identified essential upgradations prescribed to the cinema, advancements of past decades not compatible with the law. New trends and market neglected by the administration. New trends and market means digitalization and DVD markets. Web cinema is the new markets and trends existing nowadays. Recommendations. Government should give the priority to uplift the industry considering an economic factor, art and culture, that is a threefold program. Abolish the NFC by repealing the act and establish a film certification and rating board like India. Indian model is one of successful models in the world. And the industrial responsibility should be taken by the Minister of Industries, while Minister of Mass Media should hold the responsibility of art, technicians and artists, because industry means it should have a sense of industry, especially, and redefine all important terms included in the NFC Act in addition to new terms, because no digitalization, no new modes defined in the act. And film industry should accept from all taxes for a certain period and eliminate entertainment tax. Entertainment tax is very old tax because the celluloid are highly inflammable, because therefore theater owners had to pay a lot of 10% of the ticket to the local government body to keep fire brigade standby. Appoint a permanent committee to monitor and legalize technical advancement and standard support to digital cinema. And state should allow and sponsor for a monopolistic competition market and should consider to acquire a stake of it. Maintain proper scientific film archives in Sri Lanka, because the NFC, I think the NFC's NFC burnt Nidane, the film that it's like treasure for Sri Lankan cinema, Nidane, because of lack of film archiving methods. And lastly, This is the problem. They always ask because over 400 staff is maintaining by the corporation from the public.